Foreign investments coursed through the Philippine Central Bank climbed further in May. The $1.1 billion registered investments last month were up by 15% from the $914 million in April. That figure is also higher than $845 million year on year. Most of the investments were in equity-listed securities and peso-denominated securities. These were channeled to banks, property, and mining, among others. The United Kingdom was the biggest source of foreign investments, followed by the U.S., Singapore, as well as Luxembourg and Norway. Philippine mobile e-wallet GCash assures customers their funds are safe following reports of an alleged data breach. GCash says its initial findings saw no indications of a data leak in its systems, but it assures the public they are closely working with authorities on the matter. GCash executives met with the Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center for an assessment of the reported data breach. Cyber advocacy group Deep Web Connect earlier reported GCash customer data such as IDs, selfies, and signatures were exposed online. Still on the NBA, Filipino-American Jared Lucas joins the defending Western Conference champion, the Dallas Mavericks. After going undrafted last year, Lucas will now be with the Mavericks in time for the NBA Summer League. He spent his college seasons in Oregon State and Nevada, averaging 18 points per game last year.
Just the tip of the iceberg. That's how Senator Sherwin Gatchalian describes the case of suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go, who has been exposed as a fake Filipino. The National Bureau of Investigation revealed Thursday Go's fingerprints matched those of Chinese national Go Wa Ping. Go's lawyer, however, was mum on the findings of the NBI. Attorney Stephen David says it's too early to comment on the issue since they have yet to examine the documents and their sources. But for Senator Gatchalian, what's clear is that foreign nationals can easily abuse the country's flawed birth registration system.
Go Wa Ping is just the tip of the iceberg. We haven't really tightened the process for late registration and birth certificate system of the country. They impose certain new guidelines, but the process remains largely the same. So, in other words, it is still prone to abuse. And I believe that because the system is flawed, that a lot of foreigners exploited this flawed system. I believe that there are still a lot of Alice Goes out there who exploited the system. And that is the dangerous part in our country right now, that we have illegal foreigners, fake Filipinos who can buy land, who can enter into business and eventually run for public office. And this loophole presents a national security threat.
As for Senator Risa Ontiveros, she believes the matching fingerprints are the single strongest piece of evidence that could remove Mayor Go from office. For Ontiveros, there is no need to conduct a third-party analysis of the fingerprints.
Their findings on this are gold dahil 100% na patunayan nila na yung Guo Huaping na na-affix yung fingerprint dun sa pag-apply para sa earlier special investment resident visa at yung Mayor Alice Lia Guo na may fingerprints sa kanyang NBI clearance ay one and the same person. So wala nang duda dyan.